JBS here. Time for another pickups video. Normally I don't do them this close to, together, but you know, I figure why wait? You know, I got some new stuff, so I might as well show it. And this is a good mix, I think. It's let's see, I got NES a little bit, more modern stuff. It's kind of all over the board. So let's just go ahead and get started. I'll get sort of the boring stuff out of the way first. Stuff that probably that's not super important or anything. But I have a 3DS, as probably most of you know. And I used to have this DS case for my original DS, and I've just been using that as my 3DS case. Well, I was at the store the other day, and they had these 3DS cases on sale for $4. So I was like, you know what the hell, I'll go ahead and get it. And it's this cool little, like, fake leather, whatever you want to call it. It's a pretty nice material. It's nice and soft. The inside keeps the games protected. It holds two games. And for $4, yeah, this is extremely practical, which is what I like about it. Also, the pawn shop here in town, I sort of know the guys pretty well now. And he hooked me up with a pretty good deal on a Wii controller, but most importantly, it's the Wii Motion Plus. This was $15, and usually they're about $25, sometimes even more. And this is like brand new, so I had no problem paying that. My first Wii Motion Plus controller, which you actually need to play a few games. Okay, alright, this was a garage sale pickup, and it's a game that I don't think I've shown this yet. I actually got it a while ago, but I don't think I've shown it. And it's a game for the Wii, and it was only like $2 or $3, I think. And I already have this game, and it's Wii Sports. So first off, let me just say, if anybody wants Wii Sports, I'm selling this, because it's a double. But the reason I got it was because, along with Wii Sports being inside, Wii Sports Resort was inside, which is another Wii Motion Plus required game, and I don't have this. So to get both games for like $3 is very nice. Wii Sports Resort didn't come with its original case, but I'm thinking maybe I can make one or find one on eBay or something. And hopefully I can get that complete. Alright, let's see. I'll bring this stuff over here. Alright, this is a Goodwill pickup here that, it's a game I really don't have any intention of playing. In fact, I can't because I don't even have the system. And it's for the PS1, but I picked it up basically just to resell. It's, Psychic Detective. It's a long box game, which I've actually never had. I saw it online go for a decent amount, so I thought, you know, I'd pick it up, try and sell it. It's a little scratched, not terrible, but a little bit. The case is in very good condition, actually. These are pretty cool cases, to be honest. And, so if somebody is interested, I guess, just let me know. If not, I'm probably just going to put it up on eBay and hope for the best. Alright, another eBay pickup here. Now, a while ago, I started sort of liquidating some of my Nintendo games. And I either got rid of them because they were doubles, a few games I didn't want, or I had the intention of picking them up at a later time in box. Well, that's the case for one of these, and it completes the trilogy, sort of, if you will, on the NES, and it's Super C, complete in box. Now, the box is in, it's kind of like a tale of two stories here. This side and the front are, like, perfect. This side has a little crushing, and the back has a little tear up here. It's not bad, it doesn't really bother me, but, and then the bottom's very nice, the top's very nice, everything else is very nice on it. So I was happy to get this. That was $21.95, by the way, which I was very, very, you know, I'd pay that no problem. It's definitely worth that. Okay, so this next, set these over here. These next two games are some from, Kefka 14. He was selling a few things, and, I bought them from him. A couple 64 games here. The first one is Mario Party 3. Probably my least favorite of the Mario Party series on the 64, but I got it anyway. And then this is just a classic, you have to have this. It's, Super Smash Brothers. I had this growing up, got rid of it, got it again. Something I didn't get out, because I actually forgot about it when preparing for the video, but, I'll go ahead and grab it real quick. He had an extra He had an extra manual for Final Fantasy III. I don't want to get it out because it's already in here. But it was like the last thing I needed to complete this. I have like the map and all that. So finally I have a complete Final Fantasy III in very good shape. The manual's a little rough, and he told me that. But I was happy with it. No problems. I'll fix that later. So yeah, thanks to Kefka for the manual and the 264 games. Definitely check him out. Really good friend of mine here. One of the first video or channels I started watching when I first started doing the YouTube watching and all that, when I first found out that people actually did this. So definitely check him out, and you probably won't regret it. So yeah. Alright, next is basically some more modern or last generation stuff. This first one was on, I think it was Atari Age. Yeah, I want to say it was Atari Age, and they were asking $5 a piece for GameCube games. And right now I'm really kind of hunting down some GameCube games that I want to play, and it's not really one I was after, but when I saw the price I really couldn't pass it up. It's Kirby Air Ride. And it's usually about a $10 to $15 game, I think, and for $5, I scooped this up pretty quick. I haven't played it yet, I literally just got it today, but I've heard it's not that great, but I figured I'd give it a shot anyway. It's Kirby, so it can't be terrible. Okay, now these next three things are excellent, they really are. Let's see, so I just beat Skyward Sword, Zelda on the Wii, and it's kind of like, I don't know, probably one of my favorite Wii games, if not my favorite Wii game, and I've been on a Zelda kick lately, so I beat Ocarina of Time the other day, I finished that up, shortly before that happened, I beat Skyward Sword, so I've been kind of on a Zelda kick lately, and so I wanted to keep my Zelda going, I want to keep playing these Zelda games, so I went ahead and picked up some really great titles here. Alright, let's start with probably the least excellent of the, well, not excellent, but the least notable. It's Twilight Princess on the Wii, and I'm not saying least notable as in, an opinion on the game. I've heard it's fantastic, but it's a pretty cheap game. You can get it on Amazon, I think, for $13. I got this at GameStop. Unfortunately, I had to pay, I think, $17 for it. But, you know, that's okay. Just to pay a few extra bucks to have the copy right now instead of have to wait for shipping is very cool. I plan on starting this probably today, and I really am anxious. So the next two are games I've been wanting for a while, but they always tend to be annoyingly priced. And I use that term often when describing things. Each system seems to have its own annoying price. The Genesis, it's like $15 to $20. That's annoying for me to pay that much for some games. You know, some games I will, but it's annoying. The GameCube, it's around that $25 to $30 range. The NES, it's like $15. Those prices annoy me. I don't know why. It's because a lot of games are around that price or something. But these do fit that price, but these cost me a total of $15 for both of them. One of them I actually got for free. I'll save that for last. But this one's missing the manual, and I've heard mixed things about this game. I've heard it's one of the best, but I've also heard people complain. It's The Legend of Zelda Wind Waker, and like I said, there's no manual with this one, but I did order a manual off eBay, so I'll have a complete copy. And this was $15, and I actually had a Wind Waker case already. So I sold that on eBay. Surprisingly, somebody paid $15 for it. So this literally almost cost me nothing. So that's pretty cool. And then the manual, that cost me $5. So I got that coming. That one, I don't know when I'm going to play. It'll probably be after Twilight Princess. But I can't say for sure. Okay, so this one was free. 100% free. Ran into an old friend of mine. And we got... Sorry about that. And we got to talking. And I knew he had this game, and I mentioned it to him. He's like, yeah, I still got that. If you want it, you can have it. I'm like, no kidding? You know, yeah. So yeah, he was true to his word. The next day, he stopped over at my house and dropped off, and I couldn't be more happy to have this. It's The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess on the GameCube, which is the much more expensive version of Twilight Princess. This one's about probably 30 plus, again, in that annoying range. sometimes more. This one is basically mint. I know he didn't play it very much. Yeah, the disc looks like literally brand new almost. Manuals all in there, all the inserts, the case looks fantastic. So that cost me nothing. So I was so happy to have that. And so this pickups video, I've gotten 3 Zelda games here. Well, literally only 2, but 3 total, I guess. Now, I don't know which one to play as far as Twilight Princess. I know it's going to be my next Zelda game is Twilight Princess, but I don't know which one to play. Now, I've heard this one's probably the better of the two, but I think I might like this one because it has the luxury of not using the motion controls. And after playing Skyward Sword, the motion controls are a little okay. You know, I could use a standard controller. But I don't know. We'll have to see. Yeah, and this one plays in widescreen, which this one doesn't. And I'll probably play them both at some point. But I just don't know which one to play first. So if you have an opinion, I guess, let me hear it, because I'd be interested to see what people think. And that's everything. So, a lot of Zelda this time around. Well, only 3 games, but, you know, that's a lot for me, I guess. So that's going to wrap it up. So, let me know what you think about the Zelda games. If anybody's interested in any of the games I said I'm selling, go ahead and shoot me a PM, and maybe we can work something out. So, thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you next time. It's a pretty nice material. It's nice and soft. The inside keeps the games protected. It holds 2 games. And for $4, yeah, this is extremely practical, which is what I like about it. Also, the pawn shop here in town, I sort of know the guys pretty well now. And he hooked me up with a pretty good deal on a Wii controller. But most importantly, it's the Wii Motion Plus. This was $15, and usually they're about $25, sometimes even more. And this is like brand new, so I had no problem paying that. My first Wii Motion Plus controller, which you actually need to play a few games. I have a 3DS, as probably most of you know, and I used to have this DS case for my original DS, and I've just been using that as my 3DS case. Well, I was at the store the other day, and they had these 3DS cases on sale for $4, so I was like, you know what the hell, I'll go ahead and get it. And it's this cool little, like, fake leather, pleather, whatever you want to call it. It's, CobraDBS here. Time for another pickups video. Normally I don't do them this close together, but you know, I figure why wait? You know, I got some new stuff, so I might as well show it. And this is a good mix, I think. It's let's see, I got NES, a little bit more modern stuff. It's kind of all over the board. So let's just go ahead and get started. I'll get sort of the boring stuff out of the way first. Stuff that's not super important or anything, but...